Hello, welcome back. Meatballs. You heard me. Meatballs. And what I'm going to do today with these meatballs, I'm going to create my vision of what is a meatball sandwich. It's unique. It's my creation, my inspiration, and I want to share with you. As a matter of fact, four of these meatballs can be a full meal for you. This is how fulfilling, how well I prepare them using my own recipe. But more importantly, it's a low-carb meal because I'm using bread with a net carb count of 0 grams. That's the bread. So the little carbs you're going to have is going to be from small things like a little bit of tomato here, tomato from the sauce, because I'm also creating a homemade quick and dirty sauce, one that you can create within 15, 20 minutes, you know, to add to that sandwich. So, not going nowhere. Let's have some fun. If you like my creation and what I'm creating here, feel free and share with others. Or subscribe. But the most important thing is, let's create. So let me introduce some of the ingredients. I have about, actually 1.04 pounds of ground beef. I'm going with the beef. I have an egg. I have about 1/4 cup of basil, Italian parsley, and about 1/4 cup of chopped onions. The parsley was also chopped. I have my homemade adobo ready to go, which consists about, I would say, 1 teaspoon of salt, turmeric, black pepper, and oregano, and a small amount of thyme, fresh. I have 3 garlic teeth, which are going to be mincing too. And of course, you're going to need some extra virgin olive oil. And this is for the part that you're going to be using to create the meatballs. I also have 3 slices of bread. I might need 2, maybe all 3 because they're small. This is a 0-carb bread. What you're going to do with this, I'm going to cut the edges out, this part. I'm going to cut it out. And then I'm going to cut the actual bread in squares, small square or rectangles. So here I have the bread. I'm going to cut the edges. I'm actually need 4 slices. Move this out of the way. Then you cut it in squares or rectangles. And once you do that, what you're going to do is you're going to put in a container with water. You don't want the water all the way up. You just want enough water to cover them. In fact, let me throw a little bit away. And you're going to let them soak in this water for about 5-7 minutes. And actually going to grab another slice. This better be prepared than sorry, right? So let me get another slice. And once again, this is the zero carbs bread, net carbs. It's very good if you want to keep it. Very low carb meal, which is in 10 of this one actually. Deliciously delicious and low carb. So you do the same with this one. Got the edges. And then cut this in rectangles. And let it soak. Yeah, this is good. It's 5-7 minutes. So before I go to the next step of the meatballs, I'm going to prepare what I call a quick and dirty tomato sauce. You can use any type of tomato sauce. And what I have here, mixed together, I put them all together at the same time, I mix them here. I had very small tomato. I have some, you know, a little bit of red and green bell pepper. If you were to chop them, that would be about a tablespoon together, combined. I have about a tablespoon and a half of onions, 2 minced garlic, a half a teaspoon of oregano, which I chopped very thinly. I have about a tablespoon of Italian parsley, about half of a teaspoon of thyme. Of course, I have the extra virgin olive oil, which I put generously here. I also have some ground black pepper. And I added 3 caps of vinegar. With the cap, I mean the cap that goes on top of the vinegar bottle. I just 3 caps. It's been cooking for like 5 minutes. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to add a handful of parsley. Also add some onions. I think I mentioned I have a tablespoon and a half of onions in case I forgot to mention. You can use any type of tomato sauce that you decide to use. You can make whatever type you want to make. If you want to prepare one that takes a long time to prepare, that I have done long before, you can do that. But I'm not going to invest a lot of time on this. You can add salt if you feel you need some more salt. It's up to you. You just let it cook until caramelized. So I took the excess water out, I put it in the sink and got rid of that water. So what I'm going to do now, look at that water jumping. I'm going to mix the bread. And I hope this one works because it's not your traditional bread. And I'm going to try as best as I can to make a paste with it. Some sort of paste. And I don't think I'll be able to do that, but that's fine. Let me get him some of that water. See, I had to get him some more of that water. Now, if you don't have any diet restrictions, you can use just a regular bread, which will work better. But I'm going low carb. Let me get a little more of this water now. I've seen people using, in the past, like crackers and stuff like that to create that crusty stuff in the outside of the meat, the meatballs. Some people don't use anything, but I'm going to go with the bread. The thing when you deal with alternative meals like low carb and stuff, it's a little bit more difficult to work with it. This we have to do. I will do some magic though. But once again, if you use regular bread, it's going to be more like a pasty. With this one, it's not going to be like that because it's a no-carb bread. Now it's time to mix everything. This meat have been out of the refrigerator for at least 30 minutes. It's going to get a little bit messy because you have to work with your hands. Let me add some of that bread. Mix it up. What I'm going to do now, doesn't matter the order, but I'm going to add some of the onions, some of the Italian parsley. Not all, but some. I don't think I need all. I'm going to add my homemade adobo. I'm going to mix it up here. Let me add the rest of the stuff here. I have about 2 or 3 teeth of garlic. So what I'm going to do is going to mince it real time. And this is a quick and dirty, old school lot of flavor. Lot of flavor. And what you're going to do, 1 egg. And you're going to mix with your hand. You're going to mix everything together. Don't overdo it because you don't want the thing too mushy. You know, you don't want the egg and the meat. Like, if you do it too much, it's going to be watery. So you just do it enough to mix stuff in inside, see? But still, you know, you can grab it and poop. Create a meatball. You know what I mean? That simple. So I think I have enough. See, still. Now, if you do it a lot, it's going to be like running through your fingers, you know, the meat, because of the liquid is, and it's ground meat, so it's going to dissolve more. You don't want that. So I have 6 good sized meatballs for what I want to do. Let me move this out of the way. You're going to use a pan. I'm going to go with the non-stick one. That way it's easy to manage. You're going to use a generous amount of extra virgin olive oil. I'm going Italian, Sicilian to be more specific. Have your heat on, nearly high. Let it heat up for a little bit. That way, when you put everything, it cooks at the same time evenly. I don't have this full all the way up, I just have it on the sides generously. And I'm going to let it heat up for a little bit. I want the thing to be hot. Things are ready. So you're going to put the meatballs. Because these ones are big, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cook one side for about 5 minutes. Then I'm going to turn them and cook for the same amount of time. I'm going to put the heat to medium high. So I'm lowering it. I lower the heat a little bit. And I'm going to let them cook, see what happens. Looking pretty good, the way I wanted this one. I didn't want it to, you know, I want it to be more thick, like real, real thick. But you can see some of the garlic, but you can see some of the tomatoes, some of the pepper. But I'm going to let it cook for a little bit more. Let me turn it around. See how nice? Dark. When you're cooking with big meatballs, it takes some skills to move the stuff around. Not a lot. Just be careful not to get burned. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to do the same on the other side. Let's say 5 minutes. About 2 minutes into the second time of the process after I turn them. I cook one side for 5 minutes. The other is turning them around. Cook for like 2 minutes. I cover it because I want the steam on the last 3 minutes to start working around. I don't want the heat to go up completely. I want to distribute so the size of the meatball start cooking too. Lower the heat. I put it to medium low. Yep. Let me turn them to the side for a minute or so. You have to make sure they're cooked. So turn it to one side for a minute. I'm going to do the same for the other side. See how dark and nice they look. And once it goes to a minute on one side, I'm going to turn it to the other side on the edge and cook it for a minute too also. So I turn it to the other edge side. 1 minute and we're done. At least with the gimbal. Yeah, we have it, they are ready. So what I have here is a paper plate. You can use any plate. I have some napkins, you can use paper towel. What I'm going to do, I'm going to start transferring the meatball. Here, so the grease get drained a little bit. So let's start putting my inspired meatball sandwich. I'm going to go with zero carbs type of bread.